everyone. Myself, Dr. S. Shobhna, Assistant Professor of English, the Standard 5 Works Rajaratnam College for Women, Sivakasi. Welcome to this video. Here, I am going to discuss about the following significant topics of post-colonialism and its elements. The main concept is to help the students to understand the basic introduction to post-colonial theory in literature. The purpose of this video is to focus on the following topics: emergence of post-colonialism, post-colonial literature, post-colonial theory, varieties of post-colonial theory. The topic mentioned here help us to have a good foundation with the post-colonialism. It is better to have some understanding on the basic ideas associated with post-colonial literature. In many works of literature, specifically these coming out of Africa, the Middle East, and the Indian subcontinent, we meet characters who are struggling with their identities in the wake of colonization or the establishment of colonies in another nation. For example, the British had a colonial presence in India from 17th century until India got independence in 1947. As you can imagine, the people of India as well as the character in Indian novels must deal with the economic, political and emotional effects that the British brought and left behind. This is true for literature that comes out of any colonized nation. In many cases, the literature stemming from these events and both emotional and political. The post-colonial theorist analyzed these literature through a critical lens and also asked the readers to analyze and explain the effects that colonization and imperialism or the extension of power into other nations have on people and nations. So before stepping into the subject, let us first have a glance on the difference between colonialism and post-colonialism. Colonialism means controlling or governing influence of a nation over a dependent country, territory or people. Post-colonialism refers to the time after these colonized nations have become independent. It developed from and mainly refers to the time after colonialism. Colonial literature refers to the literature that was written during the colonial period before the decolonization and often written from the perspective of the colonizer. In as much as post-colonial literature was written after the decolonization and written from the perspective of the former colonized. Colonial literature portrays colonization as a natural, unproblematic, often correct process, whereas post-colonial literature portrays the problem and consequences of colonization and decolonization. Colonial literature describes indigenous people and culture savage or primitive. Seeing that, post-colonial literature tried to attempt to describe indigenous people, places and practices to counteract the stereotypical images portrayed by the colonizers. So now we have seen the difference, and this shows us that colonial literature contains the perspective of the colonizers, where post-colonial literature is written in the perspective of the colonized or the formerly colonized people. The post-colonial direction was created as colonial countries became independent. And also we can see that both literatures are totally different from each other. So now we understand that post-colonial analyses of historical or literary documents that usually focuses on the challenges faced by one colonized and now independent people. So we can clearly see that post-colonialism is an academic discipline featuring methods of intellectual discourse that analyze, explain and respond to the cultural legals of colonialism, to the human consequences of controlling a country and establishing settlers for the economic exploitation of the native people and their land. So having covered about the colonialism, now let's dwell into the details of the post-colonialism. In this slide, we are seeing how the post-colonies emerged. While the field of post-colonial studies only began taking shape in the late 1970s and early 1980s, numerous fiction writers began publishing works in the decades immediately following World War II. Post-colonialism is an intellectual direction that exists since around the mid of the 20th century. Post-colonialism emerged in those countries which experience a direct colonial rule. It stands for the cultures and the society at margin and challenges the center-margin model with the aim of the removal of inequality. Post-colonialism makes a distance from the high culture of the elite and follows subaltern cultures and knowledge. Like colonialism, post-colonialism is a state of consciousness, a crucial phase in the continuum of our cultural process and self-awareness. So we can clearly see that the post-colonial studies analyze the politics of knowledge by examining the functional relation of social and political power that sustain colonialism. The next logical step is to cover the post-colonial literature. During last quarter of the 20th century, literary studies in particular and the studies of humanities in general moved to a new direction, which opened up a completely new field of inquiry. The study of post-colonial literature begins with the historical context of colonialism. Post-colonial literature involves in writing that deals with the issue of decolonization or the political and cultural independence of people formerly subjugated to colonial rule. It tried to attempt to reread the emergence of post-colonialism and its literary expression itself. Post-colonial literature often involved writing that deals with the issues of decolonization or the political and the cultural independence of people formerly subjugated to the colonial rule. This is what we know as a field of post-colonial literature. So moving forward, post-colonial theory examines the way in which the writers from colonized countries try to write and celebrate their cultural identities and reclaim them from the colonizers. Post-colonial theory deals with the reading and writing of literature written in previously or currently colonized countries or literature written in colonizing country which deal with colonization or colonized period. In the academic realm, post-colonialism can be seen as a tool to revisit, to rethink and to re-question the colonized past. The post-colonialism thinkers try to prevail over the humiliation of marginality or otherness by foregrounding differences and diversity. Post-colonial theory is one of the main framework for thinking about the world and acting to change the world. Let us now deal with the key themes that link to post-colonial theory in literature. It contains hybridity, mimicry, exile, displacement, identity crisis, magical realism, and diaspora. Now, let us deal with all these theory one by one. The first one, hybridity. It refers to the construction of new cultural forms within the contact religion produced by colonization. It is the assimilation of cultural symbols and practice from the colonizing to the colonized cultures. Next, mimicry. Mimicry is used to explain the rethinking of the past. As a concept, it is applicable to all the subjects of the colony, irrespective of the specific community or group they may belong to. It occurs when subjugated people crave for dominating cultural form. And the next, exile. Exile is an enforced exclusion from a known physical face. Exile keep hold of a sense of belonging to or for a real or imagined whole world. Next one, displacement. It refers to both physical displacement and a sense of being socially or cultural out of place. During the time of displacement, the immigrant are suffering from racism, resentment and a sense of rootlessness. Identity crisis. After colonization, the native feel a sense of identity crisis. The culture and tradition which the colonial masters left here made the native to feel them to identity crisis. Partition of the country was another reason for the identity crisis. Magical realism. An aesthetic style to explain the harsh reality in a normal setting. Magical realists integrate many techniques they have connected to post-colonialism. Hybridity is a primary feature. Magical realism can be used to find out realities of characters or communities who are outside of the mainstream. Last one, diaspora. Diaspora carries an implication of forced relocation of a due to exclusion, slavery, racism or war, especially national conflicts. It also refers to the people who are settled in other part of the world for employment. So these theories allow us to look on all the above mentioned areas with a new sight and celebrate the culture that exists in the world. So now we had looked the theories. Let's see how the postcolonial writers portrayed these theories into literature. Postcolonial writers describe native people, places and practices to counteract the accurate, generalized stereotype created by the colonizers. Postcolonial writers invent new words, syntax and style. These writers also reshape and rework colonial art forms by incorporating indigenous styles, structures and themes such as oral poetry and dramatic performance. They also intend to find and re-establish their lost national identity, history and literature, and try to redefine the author's relationship with the land and languages of their former masters. And now, we reach at the end of the video. We can clearly see that postcolonial literature is a kind of literary work which describes realistic experience of what really happened around us, and to remind, don't just shut our eyes, since we all know that one's voice could lead into a betterment of our future and society. Hopefully, now you all got the idea on postcolonialism and its elements. Thank you. Keep learning, keep growing.